John Rebus is a man, a complicated man. He was a detective, but now he is retired. But he still wants to feel like a detective, so he finds old unsolved police cases that he can work on. And he's been with me now for 30 years. I have written about this man for 30 years. So the series of books gives you a very complete picture of a man from age 40 to age 65. I got the idea for the latest book because there was a television documentary about business practice and corruption in business in Scotland. And I thought it was very interesting that such a small country could have a very complex financial fraud that was global and involved billions of euros. And so that was the story in the present day. But Rebus is also investigating a case from the past. Again, it's based loosely on a true story of a rich woman who disappeared with her child and was never found. I've taken that story, and in my version, she is killed in a hotel, a five-star hotel, Très Chic, Edinburgh. Rebus was originally a detective on that case. It was never solved, and so he's interested in bringing some closure, a completeness to the case. I've published a collection of Rebus short stories, Les Nouvelles de Rebus, because the short story gives you a different, each story gives you a different part of his character, a different part of his personality. The stories are not quite as dark, not quite as gothic or as noir as the novels. They're set at Christmas, at Noel. There are jokes, they're quite funny, they're quite light. But in them you get a sense that Rebus is a man who lives to solve mysteries. Life is a mystery, and we all go through life trying to find answers to our many questions, and that's what Rebus does in every one of these very short stories. I began writing stories about Edinburgh, the city where I live. I was a student there, and I wanted to make sense of the city of Edinburgh. And in doing that, I began to realize I needed to understand the world. And the detective novel, the detective story, is a good way of investigating society from the people at the very top to the people at the very bottom. And Rebus is an anarchist. He's a man who will help you if you're poor, if you're committing a crime because you need the money to feed your family. He's okay with that. If you're rich, if you're a bureaucrat, an oligarch, an industrialist, and you're cheating to make more money that you don't really need, then Rebus will cut you. In the early books, Rebus is 40 years old. Now, in the present day, he's in his mid to late 60s. So he's a different person. He cannot get into fights with people. He cannot intimidate suspects the way he used to. He uses his intelligence. Everything that he has learned from all his years as a police officer, he uses that instead of using just muscle to get answers to questions. But he's living in a very different Scotland. The Scotland that I wrote about 30 years ago no longer exists. Now there is nationalism, there is Brexit, there are new economic issues, problems for people. The World Wide Web has arrived, social media has arrived, the internet. Rebus has to deal with this very changing world, and he's confused. He's like me. Much of the modern world confuses me. And so Rebus is my way of trying to explore the changes that are happening in our world right now and in the future. Pour l'avenir. Excusez-moi, je ne parle pas français très bien. Je suis comme un enfant écossais quand on parle français. C'est bon à parler des tronçonneuses, comme quelque chose comme ça, mais pas la littérature, pas Proust, pas Sartre. Mais j'espère, j'ai espérance. Rebus, il est un caractère très complexe, très intéressant, et pour le lecteur français, j'ai l'espérance, il est un ami qui vous aime.